So, look, this is a very significant inquiry. It's probably the largest inquiry that this committee has undertaken in the history of the 59th Parliament. But it was referred by the House to the committee, and we were required to look at the decline in our ecosystems in Victoria. So we heard from a range of individuals and organisations who were required to address the terms of reference, and many made submissions and gave evidence about their particular parts of the world, but also we heard from scientists, experts in the field, and we gathered there was a large range of evidence that the committee had to consider, all talking about the various impacts on ecosystem decline in Victoria. So one of the things the committee was very fortunate to see was a demonstration on Yorta Yorta land on how our Indigenous First Nations people use cultural fire practices. And it was incredible to watch the importance and the role that fire can play in the landscape. And the committee was very fortunate to see that, and I'm really grateful. I'd just like to mention Victor Stephenson from the Fire Sticks Alliance, who very graciously educated all of us in the use of cultural fire practices. And what we saw and what our First Nations people are telling us is that fire also plays an important role in the landscape, particularly for the health of some of our native grasses as well. So those cultural fire practices are quite different to some of the Western fire practices that are used in the landscape as well. And fire and water together play a very important role in keeping the health of our country, improving the health of our country as well. What the committee found was there are a number of drivers to ecosystem decline. And significantly, climate change is one of those main drivers, but also habitat destruction and human impacts on our biodiversity as well. So there are significant drivers to that. And so the report then looks at the consequences of that and how we might go about reversing them. The health of our ecosystems impacts our own human health, not only our physical health, but also our mental health. And generally what you'll find is when there's an imbalance in our ecosystems, things do get out of balance. So perhaps where you look at, you'll see an overpreponderance of pest or invasive species, whether it's weed species or animal species. So we find that those things are out of kilter, and that can be a consequence of ecosystem decline. So our native species begin to be under pressure and decline. So we've also found that there are a number of species that are on threatened list, or some have become extinct as well. So it's really important to arrest ecosystem decline so we find that we don't have any more species become threatened or become extinct. What the committee wanted to do was give more agency to our First Nations people to have a greater role in how to care for country. And so some of the recommendations you'll find, there's a recommendation in there about trialling the return of the dingo as an apex predator into the environment. Because what we know is that the apex predator, it's incredibly important to our First Nations people, but it also does a great job in clearing up pest species as well. So there's one recommendation there to return the apex predator, the dingo, to the landscape in a trial, so we can also study that trial. Because the committee heard evidence that not only was the dingo able to clean up pest species, but we saw there has been some evidence about the return of native grasses and the like to some of our lands, which is important for soil health. So these things are all connected, and I think that's been poorly understood perhaps by Western European peoples, that you know, impact of one ecosystem, if it's in decline, can certainly have knock-on effects to others. So we're looking forward to seeing that, if it's accepted by government, that trial commence so we can study the impacts of that. And another recommendation was to also look at the phase out of 1080 baits. 1080 baits is used by government and other agencies to control pest species. But what we're seeing is increasing amounts of concern about the humane use of that and how it impacts animals when they're dying. But also then the downstream effects, if you like, about what happens once that animal that's been killed is consumed by other species. So one of the recommendations goes to looking at that. So wanting to take a more humane approach to controlling pest species and calling for more research into more humane methods of control, like birth control and the like.